came to earth, the prophet Isaiah said, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace." And we're celebrating that Savior today. And as the Christmas story tells us, when the wise men came in the presence of that baby Jesus, they bowed down and worshiped him. And that's what we're going to do this morning. Amen. So stand up as we sing his praises, sing glorious.
My eyes have seen.
in his graciousness and his grace. You may be seated. Let's all see if we could scoot in towards the middle. We got still more people wanting to come in, want to make room for them. We still want to get everyone in here that we can. So I know you might have your favorite seat, but give it up. What a wonderful day we have to sing his praises. And part of our worship is in the giving and the offering as the ushers prepare. We just ask now in Jesus' name, Lord, that you would bless this offering. We ask you, O Lord, to receive it as gifts from us, though we're not so wise so many times. But we are wise enough to recognize that all that we have and all that we are comes from above. And we look to, O Lord, that heavenly kingdom that you have promised all those who believe, and that living hope that you've given us that will never spoil, perish, or fade. And we with joy give to you, Lord, knowing because of that gift you gave to us, in Jesus' name. And they all said amen. One, two, three, four.
Oh, star shall come forth from the land of
Israel.
Israel. But Malchior.
The words speak to the very pattern I've been watching.
Balthazar, if what the prophet says here is true, a new Messiah could come within our own lifetimes.
There is a star that has been moving toward what the Romans call Jupiter. If the two of them draw close to each other.
How many years from now?
It will not be years.
The star is here. Jupiter is here. But look.
Another star.
No. Venus, if I'm correct. And I usually am. All three will appear to touch for the first time in 3,000 years. Venus is called the mother planet. Jupiter, the shining father. Don't you see? Mother and father aligned in the heavens as one.
And the star itself?
It is called Sharu.
Babylonian.
For king.
His wife.
Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, King of the world, who sanctified Israel by chuppah and betrothal.
Take it. The law says you will stay with us for another year. Then you will go into his house.
You will consider him your husband now. in all manner, except that which leads to family. On that, you must wait.
I'm building a house. Enough for a family.
I'll talk to him.
Is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Come, you will conceive in your womb and give birth to a son, and you will call his name Jesus.
How can this be, since I've been with no man?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power from the Most High will overshadow you. And the holy offspring shall be called the Son of God.
Son of God?
Mary, even your cousin Elizabeth has conceived a son in her old age. For nothing said by God can be impossible.
Let it be done to me, according to your word.
Thank you.
Joseph, fear not. For that which is conceived in Mary is of the Holy Spirit.
Mary. And you shall call his name Jesus. For it is he who will save his people from their sins. I know. Mary, God showed me. An angel came to me in my dream.
Believe me.
I believe you.
Your child will need a father. I will declare him as my own.
People, they will not look at you the same. They will not look at us the same.
You are my wife. I am your husband. That is all anyone need know.
Messiah has come. Unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. You will find a child wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
He is for all mankind. We are each given a gift.
Greatest of kings, born in the most humble of places. God made into flesh.
Gift of myrrh to honor thy sacrifice.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Mary. God is crazy about you. He wants to use you.
Hi, Mary. God's crazy about you.
Hi, Mary. That's crazy about you.
Hi, Mary. God's crazy about you.
Hi, Mary. God's crazy about you, and he wants to use you.
Don't be afraid, Mary. God's on your side.
Don't be afraid, Mary. God's on your side.
Don't be afraid, Mary. God's on your side.
And he has a big surprise. You're going to have a baby, and his name's going to be Jesus.
He'll become great.
And he will be called the Son of the Most High.
How's this going to happen? I'm a virgin.
The Holy Spirit will do it.
I'm the Lord's servant, so it's fine with me. But Mary treasured up all these feelings.
Don't be afraid. I only celebrate joy.
Don't be afraid. I have good news.
Don't be afraid. I got good news.
Today, in the town of David, the Savior has been born.
He'll be great, and he'll be called the Son of the Most High.
And his kingdom will never end.
He is Christ the Lord.
And this will be a sign.
You'll find the baby wrapped in cloth and lying down on a board.
Glory of God of the highest.
Let's go to Bethlehem and see what happened.
Let's go to Bethlehem and see what happened. Let's go to Bethlehem and see what happened.
Oh yay, I want SpongeBob Legos.
The new PSP and a DSi 3D.
A Lego set.
What do you want for Christmas?
Everything! I want a rocket ship.
An art studio. And other stuff.
What's a Lego?
A car.
Mini car that you can drive.
A mini car.
And then it's like a sand dune driver.
Yeah, it's up to my age, so I can still ride with him for another
cool.
Year.
And I want a big train and a big stocking.
I want
shirt.
Sure. I want a puppy. I'll go with that. I like puppies. Or a baby goat.
Baby goats.
That's
nice.
An angel.
You want an angel on the Christmas tree?
Yeah, and a camera.
I want a molten ball.
I think I have to guess what I want. Well, I got a Spider-Man punching thing last time, but I couldn't find it. I really wanted to punch it last time, but I'm gonna have to get a different one for Christmas. But my mom and dad went to Toys R Us, and I bought just one toy, and Aiden bought one toy, and Garen bought one toy, and just, it's actually, and I told my dad that he has to go back to Toys R Us, and he's getting a lot of more toys than us. And he's actually gonna have to come to Toys R Us again because he's gonna say, wait, you're right? You're exactly right. You're gonna give us a lot of toys, and I have to give you a lot of toys. Doesn't mean it's not fair.
I would like to give me him. That's a good present.
With wings and a ring up top.
He's white, he has wings, and he has a halo around his head.
Can I look like God's servant?
It'd probably be like filled with like just one person and then lights in the back of them and
sparkles
and wings and.
Still looks like.
It has a head and has wings, has body and legs.
Like a white bird.
It has blue round it, like it's like a Enja, but it's not. It has weird dress. Like I don't have weird dress, but sometimes my mom gives me color shirts and I like those. But I have weird dresses, but they were old and my mom had to put them back to a dress store.
I would just be stunned. I wouldn't say anything.
What are you doing here?
Nothing. I'd be too afraid to say anything. Or maybe, hey, what's up? How's it in heaven?
Nervously.
I would say...
Let's say a baby will come and celebrate and save your life.
What do you think you would say?
I'll say, okay.
Merry Christmas!
All right, give the hand to the kids. Isn't it a wonderful time to just celebrate the birth of Jesus? And it really is happy birthday, Jesus time. I kept saying that to everybody. I don't know if some people aren't ready for that, but that's exactly what it is, isn't it? It's the birth of our Savior. I want to turn over to Matthew. We're going to do really short. And kids, you listen in, okay? And make sure your parents stay nice and quiet, okay? You keep them quiet and make them sit still in their seats. In Matthew chapter 2, it says, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi, you know those three kings we saw in the movie? Those Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and they asked, where is the one who has been born of the King of the Jews? And now when you skip down, it says in verse 9, after they had heard the king, they went on their way, and in the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. And on coming into the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and they worshiped him. And they opened their treasures and they presented him with gifts of what? Three things: gold and incense and myrrh. Gold, incense, and myrrh, or gold and frankincense and myrrh. It's the same word. And so I just wanted to just think about that a little bit. That was in our film. It's such a beautiful place. Because in those three gifts that the Magi gave in worship to the Lord Jesus Christ, we see who Jesus really is. We see what he came for. And we saw what it would cost him in those gifts. The first gift was what? Gold, right? Gold speaks of deity. It speaks of God. It speaks of purity. I don't know if you realize this, but the Bible declares that Jesus is the God of the universe. He's not just a man that was a good guy and we kind of elevated him to some position of being the Son of God, but he was God throughout all eternity who created us. And because he loves us, he became flesh like us and lived a pure life. And so that gold speaks of his deity. And it speaks of the purity of his life. Because you see, in all the ways that we sin, every single day, all of us, Jesus never sinned once. In 30 some odd years of his life, he never sinned, not only in what he did and didn't do, he was perfect in that way, but also because he was God in the flesh, he did not sin even in his mind, in his thought life. in his motives, all those things that, I'll tell you what, we all fall short on, don't we? And that's what the scriptures declare. All have sinned. All have fallen short of the glory of God. But Jesus is the one who lived a pure life. Gold speaks of purity. It speaks of him being the king and him being deity, that God came down in flesh on that day, that first Christmas day. What was the second gift? Remember? It was frankincense or incense, right? Because frankincense had to do with incense. It's this beautiful, beautiful smell. Well, that has something to do with what Jesus did also, because he came as a high priest. Basically, that's what the priests would do, is they would light the incense in the temple, and they would use frankincense to do that. And so Jesus also came for all of us, mankind, to be that bridge builder, to go between us and all of our failures and all of the things that we do wrong, doop-de-doos as we all are, that he would come in between us and build a bridge between us and a holy, righteous God. You see, the truth is, because of what Jesus did, being that mediator between man and God, God's not angry at you. God's not mad at you. God loves you, and he cares about you, and he wants you to know that he has provided a way that your sins can be forgiven. That no one here need leave this building without knowing that they are forgiven by the love of God and that provision, that work that Jesus did. You know, the high priest would always bring a sacrifice to the altar, and it would be the sacrifice for all of the people of Jerusalem and all of the people of Israel. But the wonderful thing about Jesus is he offered himself for us, his righteous life for all our sin. Matter of fact, the Bible says, he who knew no sin, Jesus, became sin for us so that we might become the righteousness of God. What a beautiful gift it is that Jesus put under the tree of Calvary when he died on the cross. Because what it is an ability that God would just wipe away our sins, forget all that we've ever done against him, and credit us with the perfect life that Jesus, only Jesus, lived. And so that beautiful frankincense is that pleasing aroma unto God, that one sacrifice for all of our sins. He came as a priest. What was the last gift? Myrrh. Well, we don't have much myrrh around the United States, but that's something that was used greatly back in the day. It was used in funerals. It was used as an embalming spice. It originated in the Egyptian culture when Israel was for 400 years in the bondage of Egypt. They learned this practice. It's called mummification, right? And they did the very same thing on their burial practices. You see, Jesus came to die for mankind, to die for our sins, to be judged for us. He is not like some people's gods today would say, okay, go and blow yourself up and die for me, and then you can come to heaven and get some goodies up there. But rather he is, I've died for you. I've become the sacrifice. And so that beautiful myrrh was something that was used even in his death. As they wrapped him in bandages, as the Egyptians would with their death practices, Jesus was wrapped in bandages with myrrh, and myrrh was like a very aromatic resin, and it would harden immediately in the air, and so that was part of these bandages that were all around his body. But guess what happened? After 3 days of being in the tomb dead, he rose from the dead because, you see, he kind of put it all on the line. And he said, you know what? Destroy this temple and I will raise it up in 3 days. That's my ultimate sign that I am the Son of God, that I've done what I've done. It's interesting that myrrh was part of the evidence, one of the evidences of the resurrection. Because as Peter ran to the tomb to see what had happened on that third day, as he opened, the tomb was opened up by an angel. He ran in and it says he saw the grave clothes lying there and he believed. He saw and he believed, because what he saw was the effect of the myrrh that had hardened the bandages that were wrapped around the body of Jesus, but Jesus' body was no longer there. They were an empty cocoon. And it was one of those great evidences that led Peter to give his life for the Lord. And back in that day, it meant if you, and sometimes today in this world today in other places, to give your life and to believe upon Jesus as your Lord and your Savior and your Messiah might end up costing you your life. And it was for Peter. He was ended up being crucified for the honor of Jesus Christ because he knew that he served a risen Savior because he saw the evidence of the myrrh on the bandages. He was willing to give his life up for what he knew was the truth, that Jesus had done what he had said. And so we see the beautiful thing in these three gifts, right? But I want to tell you, and we're going to close right now, but I want to tell you that all these three gifts represent Jesus, but there is one gift under a tree. It is a tree of Calvary where Jesus died on the cross for you. We have a representation here. He died on the cross for you. And you, if you can even envision this on that cross right there, that God says that he took all of our sins, all of the record of our sins. And he, when Jesus died for us, he nailed it to the cross, basically. Nailing it to the cross in the sense that everything that you've ever wronged God in or not done that you should have done, all of these sins that bring guilt in our lives, the way that we've lived our lives, has been dealt with once and for all by Jesus Christ dying on the cross for our sins. That's the glorious thing. And you can know forgiveness today because it is a free forgiveness. Jesus paid the price for you. He is the initiator. He came to love on you. He came to die for you. And all he asked for you to do, but he says this unapologetically, that we must humble ourselves and recognize that we are sinners and realize that and admit that. We must also recognize that Jesus is the way and the truth and the life, and no man comes to the Father but through him. And so we need to bow our knee to him in our hearts, and we need to humble ourselves and receive by believing Jesus Christ died for me on the cross. Receiving Jesus Christ into our hearts and in our lives, and he will begin a personal relationship with you. And that is it, really. That is it on our part. There's a whole lot that Jesus will teach you and build you up and change your life. But I'm going to tell you, all of us up here on the platform, as we have all experienced the new life of Jesus Christ. And so I'd like you to just bow your heads, and we're going to give thanks, and we're going to have another song at the end. But I want to give you a chance today to just receive the forgiveness of the Lord Jesus Christ. Would you do that? And band, you can come up. Well, Father God, I thank you for this wonderful time. We thank you for our kids that did such a wonderful job on the little videos that we did. Thank you, Lord, for the good celebration, Lord. Thank you for this time of the year when we realize it's about giving. It's about the gift of life that you have provided for us. It is a joyous time, Lord. And Father God, I don't know, there's some here that are here because you've drawn them for this very time. Maybe they've heard it all before, but somehow, some way, today it means something different. And they want to just receive that forgiveness of the Lord. They want to accept you as their king and their master and their priest, and also the one who died for them, Lord, and rose again. And so, Father, I want to pray for those many that might just right there while heads are bowed, eyes are closed. We're not going to embarrass you. We're not going to make you do anything or get you up. We're not going to sign you up. We don't want your money. We just want you to be right with God. And if you would like to be forgiven by Jesus, if you'd like to commit your life and believe upon him today, I want you just to raise your hand, and I'm going to pray for all of us here at this moment. Is there some that would just raise their hands? Thank you back there. Many of you all over here, how many would just raise their hands in faith and say, Jesus, I believe on you. I believe that you died for my sins. How about you kids? Any here that haven't yet believed and you want to just know that you're going to go to heaven one day? And no, oh, wow, lots of kids. Great. Anybody else? Just raise your hand. He came for all of us. Well, Lord Jesus, just pray in your heart with me. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for dying for on the cross for our sins. We thank you for that you live, Lord, today. And we just need your help, Lord. We admit that we fall short, that we're, Lord, sinners. And Lord, you died for those sins. You paid the price. And Lord, we trust you. And we ask you, Jesus, to be the King in our lives. And we thank you, Lord, for all that you've done. Make yourself real to us now in Jesus' name. Everybody said, amen. Hey, let's stand up for our last song together called We Are.
Every shame, every fear, every pain, live inside the dark. That's not who we are. We are the children of the day. So wake up, sleep, and lift your head. We were meant for more than this. Fight the shadows.
Bless you on your way home. Hey, go down to our cafe down at the end of the building. We've got some goodies for you down there. We'd love to have you stick around and meet us. God bless you. Have a great, great week, a great vacation time, and a great time with your family. God bless you, and may Jesus be blessed.